Scavenge Audio. Thank you for listening to the Starburns Audio Podcast Network. We have so many great comedy shows to add to your playlist. Just last week on Starburns Audio, on the season 2 premiere of Humans Who Make Games, Adam Conover talks to comedian Ron Funches and Jean Goudon, creative director of the Assassin's Creed series. On Boogie Monster, Kyle Kinane and Dave Stone share a perfect recipe for the quarantined cook. This week on Profiles and Eccentricity, they cover the history of the Khorasan Unity cult, folks for whom a flat earth is ridiculous because they believe it's really a concave shell. Search Starburns Audio on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or any podcast platform for our full list of shows featuring hosts like Joe Coy, Amanda Seals, Jessica Chobot, and Jackie Johnson. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Starburns Audio. Enjoy the show. Stay safe, stay healthy, and keep laughing.
Till the tears run down from my eyes, Lord, somebody, ooh, somebody, can anybody find me somebody to love?
Alexa, play hits from Queen.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
There's a new podcast app that delivers chilling true crime stories straight to your mobile device. Every day, they release a new episode that investigates the gruesome true acts of America's worst serial killers, and you can explore into the minds of psychopaths and murderers.
To get started, find and download Murder Minute from the App Store or visit murderminute.com. That's MURDERMINUTE.com to get your daily dose of true crime creepiness delivered straight to your mobile device.
Do you like comedy podcasts?
No!
I do, and that's why I have one, with you.
Oh, good.
I'm Dave Ross.
I'm Hampton Young.
And we host Suicide Buddies on Starburns Audio.
That's right. It's a mental health podcast. It's about depression. It's about suicide. It's also about history, and it's also about...
having fun.
Dave and I having a blast.
Yeah, we talk about suicidal thoughts in us and other people, because we've dealt with that stuff, so we joke around about it, try to bring some light to the subject.
Yeah, who are we talking about this week?
This week we're talking about Jean Weber, a French serial killer who committed suicide in 1910.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa.
Serial and killers? I like both.
Oh, no.
No.
You're going to hate this episode, then.
Listen to Suicide Buddies on Starburns Audio. You can find it wherever you get your podcasts. Stitcher, Spotify, iTunes, wherever.
My butt.
I love you.
Bye.
Hey, guys. Sklar Brothers here with Daniel Van Kirk.
I am here.
And our guest on the show is our favorite murderer because she murders this episode. Karen Kilgariff, thanks for joining.
It was my pleasure. What a joy.
We talk about swords.
Oh, yeah.
Sword stores.
A guy who might have deserved to get attacked. Yeah. I'm not saying he did, but he might have.
He's an athlete.
Yeah.
He's an athlete.
That's all you need to know.
Talk about Claudia and her life changes.
Tiny Sasquatches. Tiny Sasquatches.
And the Sheboygan Clogger.
We need the town's help on that one.
This is it. It is Sword Stores, Tiny Sasquatches, and the Sheboygan Clogger with Karen Kilgariff. You have to listen to this week's episode of Dumb People Town.
It's the Starburns Industries Tape of the Month Club. 12 original cassette tapes delivered to your door. Each month, you'll receive a crisp new cassette tape of auditory delights made by some of the most funky and creative artists around. Featuring Dino Stamatopoulos, Natalie Palamides, Johnny Pemberton, Dan Harmon, future Ladies of Wrestling, Alan Resnick and Dina Kalberman, Dynasty Handbag, Jeff B. Davis, Rob Schraub, Lance Bangs, DJ Doug Pound, Kron, Open Mike Eagle, Ron Lynch, and on and on and on. Subscribe now. $13 gets you a crisp, unique tape in the mail each month. For $20, you receive a portable cassette player so you can listen to your tapes on the go. Here's how to order. For credit card customers, please call 747-888-0945. That's 747-888-0945. Or save COD charges and log onto the World Wide Web at d.rip/SBI-PRESS. It's a good deal.
Dan and Randy.
Jay will share tales of folks so unaware they lack embrace and sometimes choose. The life they choose will make the news. Breaking down each epic fail in Florida, there's half price bail. I'm happy to say they couldn't make this up. So listen to our podcast jam with co-host Arm and Dan. Benders, don't be a jerk. Cause when the music breaks, the funny hits, we are gonna take you down. Stick around. Make a sound, calm down, it's Dumb People Town.
Hey, Townies, welcome to a mini episode of Dumb People Town. Population you.
Population McCullough.
Hi, Julian.
That felt mean.
No. There's no meanness
here.
There's
nothing mean.
Our guest today on this mini is one of our favorite comedians. He is such a great stand-up. There, you have so many, like, classic bits that I enjoy.
Oh, thank you. I didn't know that.
Babysitter's Club.
Yeah, I put a lot of time into that one.
As high as it gets on the list of one of my... just put it this way. I booked you for my school benefit. And, like, we've had amazing people on that thing, and their expectations are super high, and I'm like, I know you will kill this
You'll
show.
You'll deliver because you are that good. And then we just did your amazing podcast, The Soft Spot.
Yes, and you guys really revealed just enough. You really you got deep. You got soft.
Happy to get deep and happy to get soft. And someone else you should have on your podcast who's sitting to my left right here, Daniel Van Kirk.
He is absolutely on the, but I couldn't get all three. I mean, it's just.
No. He should have his own.
No, Dan deserves his own.
I actually don't want to do it.
You don't want to do it?
Wait, why?
Do you not have any soft spots?
I do.
He has a lot of soft spots.
Are you from Boston?
No. Rochelle, Illinois.
And then I always get those confused.
You should.
Well, here's the deal. The world is getting dumber, and it doesn't matter if we do it in three stories or one story, you will see how dumb this world is. And so for your weekend snack that we offer for you right now, Daniel, we have stories that get sent to us by our fantastic fans, our dumb ears on the ground.
You guys don't even have to work anymore.
No.
Dan's like, fuck
Dan's
you.
Dan's got a lot of work to do. And so they sent us the stories, and then Jay and I haven't heard them. You haven't heard them. Mm-mm. Dan has barely gone through them. Yep. And so in the end, the four of us riff on them. Dan, what do we have for the story for this week?
Let's do one. It was sent in by Eric James Hiltner at EJH_3K.
Eric James Hiltner, the Edward James almost. He's almost Edward James almost.
He's almost Edward James.
EJH.
He sounds like he needs a third on the end of that
one. Right? Hiltner the third?
Yeah.
He's a good contributor. He sends in a lot of stuff.
Have you ever stayed at a Hiltner?
I haven't. I am a Hiltner Honors member, but I do not. I've never stayed.
I stayed at a Hiltner Garden Suites. It's not as good as the other. Okay.
Vero Beach, Florida.
Of course.
Vero Beach.
The motherland of dumb stories.
Yes. I was just there,
You were just there?
I was. Not Vero Beach, but I was in Naples, Florida.
On the other side.
Just for the hell of it?
I just went. No, I went to do comedy gig. Off the Hook Comedy Club.
Marco
How
was
it? They moved to Naples.
Is it Off the Hook?
It was pretty great. It was. I got into it because it's Trump Town.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I got into it with people, and it was really fun. It was really fun.
Wow, good for you. I love it. All right, well, what do we got here?
There's no crying over spilled milk, but there's an arrest involving imbibed milk in Indian River County.
Did they write that or
yes,
you?
Of course they wrote. Of course. There's a guy.
No crying over spilled milk. That is the dumbest. I can't believe you didn't
read
that.
That's not even the saying. I mean, it's don't
cry
over spilled milk.
Not there's no crying in baseball.
Don't cry. Yeah. Don't cry over spilled milk is what you say to someone when they're crying. That insinuates that there's lots of crying over spilled milk.
Also, how much would A League of Their Own suck if he had been like, don't cry in baseball?
Different line.
I'm wrong.
You don't cry in baseball.
To me, that's a very underappreciated Tom Hanks role.
Oh, yeah, he was fantastic.
He's very dark. When you look at where what he's doing there coming off of Forrest Gump in Philadelphia, like he's just playing this like he's a piece of shit.
Yeah.
He's darker in that than he is in Philadelphia.
He hates kids. He's an alcoholic.
Yeah.
It's pretty great. Yeah, such a good movie.
He supports women's baseball. I mean,
what is going on?
Rockford Peaches, near Rochelle, aka Boston.
Rockford, Illinois?
Yes, it is. All right. Steve McGuffey, which sounds like a
so
mascot.
Made up, right?
He's like the guy who wanted to be the crime dog.
Yeah. Right. But
McGuffey, the crime dog. No, you're not.
Steven McGuffey. Mm-hmm. McG. I think you feel like that's the name of somebody who talks in third person.
No, that's what's on his personalized license plate.
Yeah. Right. And he's a director. But go ahead.
No, I literally was going to make the same joke, and then you just said it, and I was going to say it, like, oh, no, you just said that.
Good. Solid.
We covered
Great
it.
Great minds think alike.
Stephen McGuffey of the 1800 block of 7th Avenue, add that to the Dumb People Town walking tour, was jailed on a felony aggravated battery charge after the March 1st incident, an affidavit states. Mm-hmm. Vero Beach Police, at about 1 p.m. in the afternoon.
Oh, I love Jesus. A crime at 1 p.m.
Is that holdover from the night before, Julian?
No, it's almost too late.
Yeah. Maybe the way you party. But no, but it's 1 p.m. That's when everybody's like about to, they just had lunch, they're tired. Yeah. You don't want to commit crimes.
Yeah.
Have any of you partied all night into the next day?
No.
Yeah, we've partied all
maybe.
Night.
Maybe.
Into the next day?
No.
Yes.
I'm not talking about morning, where you're
yes.
still...
You don't party Julian? Anymore.
Huh?
You don't party
not
anymore.
Not like that, but yeah.
Okay. Julian, I mean, you what? Have, really?
Partied into 1 p.m.?
Yeah.
1 p.m. the next
From
day.
From the night
I would say,
before.
I would say the latest I've gone is where I'm like, okay, it's time to go home and be by myself.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Probably the latest is like 10 a.m., 11 a.m.,
so yeah, I think
like
I've gone maybe 7.
I've been all night... Yeah,
I've been online
and crashed today. I've stepped outside of a club and it was light out, and that was like you felt like a vampire.
Where were
here
you?
In Hollywood.
Oh,
in Hollywood, it was like over by Amoeba.
That's the
right
worst feeling,
and it was just light out. I was like, oh,
I mean, I've never done that in LA. That would be the worst feeling.
So I was
reason.
In Vegas.
Yeah, that's okay.
No idea. Like, wasn't paying attention to time or anything.
I feel like time
everything was
doesn't
fine.
Exist
I know.
In Vegas.
And then when I got to my room. I had left the curtains open, and then I saw that it was day. And I
Full
was like,
day.
Oh,
too much day.
Yeah,
too much day.
Oh, it just felt, I would have been fine if I had never known and gone. I probably could have slept 3 or 4 hours and been like, I'm good.
Now, to be clear, we're talking about you get into a game of Uno with your friends,
yes,
and it just goes crazy
course.
All night,
crazy
and you just got to keep playing.
Uno.
1 p.m. in the afternoon.
Jesus.
Police said about 1 p.m. in the afternoon, went to McGuffey's. Sounds like they're going to a bar.
So, yeah.
We're going to McGuffey's tonight.
Where only a few people know a few names.
Right.
Yeah.
You guys doing that open mic at McGuffey's?
Nah.
It does sound like an
they
open
have a
mic
sign
in
that
Chicago.
Says, we reserve the right to refuse service to nobody. Come on in. It's McGuffey's.
We reserve that right. You can't tell us who not to not serve.
Police went about 1 p.m. to McGuffey's listed address for a disturbance.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is the only next sentence. McGuffey held a wooden stick in an aggressive stance.
Okay.
It's good writing.
Uh-oh.
I don't, yeah.
You connect the dots, reader.
I know.
So he held it in an
aggressive
stance.
A wooden stick in an aggressive stance.
Okay.
McGuffey's roommate told investigators the reason for the disturbance was because McGuffey was upset with him for drinking his milk out of his glass cup.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it's not just that he drank his milk. You did it out of hit. That's my glass cup.
Why would he be mad about that? Yes.
Well, first of all, sharing dairy is the grossest thing two human beings can do. And if you
sharing dairy,
you don't share dairy. You
don't share dairy.
Sherry
sponsored our podcast.
That was Sherry's berries.
But can you imagine a grosser thing than I'm eating yogurt and I give you the spoon and I go, "Would you like a bite of this yogurt?"
No.
I mean,
I don't
it's
think
disgusting.
That's not even kosher.
I have an issue with him calling it a glass cup.
Yeah.
Like, a cup suggests plastic.
You're right.
I also picture
it's just a glass.
A glass cup? No, but
drinking
a cup.
Out of your glass, like, what did you think it was? Your glass vase?
Imagine the cup.
Please be more specific. A glass cup.
Then he took my glass cup. You took your glass. Glass cup. You didn't write cup.
For some reason, I picture a cup having a thicker lip, like, than a glass, right? It's like a thicker,
like a
mug.
Sippy cup.
Yeah,
like
a mug.
By the way,
yeah, a glass cup is a mug.
So you have a kid. That's a porcelain cup.
Oh, that's a porcelain cup.
A kid, it, like the worst idea in the world would be a glass sippy cup.
Yeah, that would
that
be.
That thing gets broke in 20
seconds.
20 seconds, that thing.
Or ever, it's like fluorescent pink and got a top for kids, and then they pick it up and I go, hey, that's glass.
Yeah, that's glass. Everything glass is telling the kid to pick
Where's
it up.
Where's my glass cup?
Yeah.
A glass, like, athletic supporting cup?
McGuffey and the roommate looked intoxicated, police reported. One in the afternoon. And you
drinking milk when you're drunk?
And
to calm down.
And if you are...
That's not a white Russian. That's a white Ukrainian.
Mm.
If you're fighting over a glass cup, you hate each other.
Yeah.
That's like we couldn't find anything else to fight over. And
or,
I guess
or,
this is going to be
we've
this.
We've already fought about everything else.
At that this point, the cup left. Is just a MacGuffin for what's really going
a
on.
A MacGuffin!
Yeah.
They looked intoxicated, police reported. they agreed to keep their distance from each other, which okay. is code for the cops wanted to do zero paperwork.
That's right. That's right. You guys got this?
You guys are good? Set?
You put the stick down? Stick down, no. Glass cut back? No. Just a glass.
This is verbally binding.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. And you guys live together, right? Yep. And you agree to stay away from each other?
We don't need to type this up.
They literally told them, keep your distance from your roommate that you're already drunk and
fighting
with.
Did they put duct tape through the middle of the floor so they couldn't cross over?
Remember that old TV trope?
Odd Couple episode.
There was like an Adams Family episode, I think, where they did that. Was a big time.
That was a big one.
That was like, if we can't think of anything else to write, let's put a line of tape down.
Do you know who the TV writer that came up with that first was?
MacGuffin.
Well, we think alike. And I was going to say Francis P. MacGuffin. But then you ruined it. Or made it better.
I'm reading your mind.
I say ruined it.
Okay.
I'm joking. They agreed to keep their distance from one another, okay. which is the cops just literally saying, we don't want to deal with either one of you.
No. Stay away from each other.
Here's, as a parent, I know what mistake they made. They didn't take the cup. They should have taken the cup.
Take the cup away.
You take the cup away. Now nobody gets a cup.
Yep. If you apart, then we'll give you back your glass cup.
Yeah. Right. Not long after that, police were sent back to the McGuffey home, believe it or not.
Really?
This time.
That seems... odd. This is now taking a left turn.
We're good, right, guys?
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah. We won't need to see you again tonight.
The two of you are fine?
Yeah, we're good.
Okay.
I'm going to stay away from him.
Don't drink his milk.
I'm going to stay away from
him. Watch me put the stick down.
Okay.
I'm going to stay away from him.
This time, McGuffey's roommate, this is when the cops come back, a second time.
Mm-hmm. Does it have a time on that one?
No.
Okay.
McGuffey's roommate said not long after. What would you say, 3:30?
Yeah, okay. Definitely.
So interior, McGuffey's apartment moments later. Right, yeah, okay.
This time, McGuffey's roommate had a big cut over his left eyebrow.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy. That's a cut that only a glass cup can make.
I know.
The roommate said, why have they not identified the roommate? We know who you live with.
Yeah.
It's I thought you were holding it back because it was John Hamm.
Someone we know.
Hammer.
The roommate said that after police left, McGuffey came at him with the stick and hit him in the head. To me, that's kind of on the cops.
We're good. Are you guys good? We're good.
Because you could have taken the glass and the stick.
You two, are you going to do exactly what we tell you not to do as soon as we leave?
We're good.
Saying stay away from each other. Right. I want to make sure that's... Just your eyes look like you're about to hit each other.
No, I'm not going
to
hit him at all.
So hit him in the head?
No.
No, do not hit him in the head.
Okay.
You don't understand. No. We're trying to say we'll leave.
Right.
Yeah. If you two say.
I won't do anything.
That's it.
You didn't do anything. You drank his milk.
I won't do anything.
When we leave, that stick. What are you going to do with that stick?
Hit him in the head.
No!
You don't understand. We're trying to leave here. You need to agree with what we're telling you. You aren't going to hit him.
I'm not going to do anything.
Finish a sentence.
You didn't do anything.
I'm not doing anything.
Stop.
I
finish
agree.
A sentence for
yes,
me. I'm
yes,
going to take this stick and...
Hit him in the
head. No! You know what? Let's just get out of here. I'm sure they'll be fine.
Yeah,
let's
they
go.
Get what we were saying.
We're not going to be here later.
We won't be back.
How many more times can they fight today?
They're out of milk.
Right. They already drank the milk.
I had the milk.
So, the roommate stated... Okay. This time, he had a roommate over his head. Hit over his head. He said that McGuffey came at him with a stick and hit him in the head. Mm-hmm. The roommate stated that it was over the initial argument about drinking the defendant's milk and using his glass cup. It's just a glass.
It's not.
It was.
I drink your milk.
So we just,
I drink your milk.
So apparently that argument about milk hadn't expired. Yeah.
At Julian McCullough.
It's at Julian McCullough.
At Jules Mac.
If you're responding to that joke, it's at Julian McCullough.
The soft spot is the podcast.
Yes. So he says it was over the initial argument about drinking the defendant's milk and using his glass cup. I love how specific they are about it.
So specific.
The roommate said that he was locked out and McGuffey wouldn't come to the door. He declined to prosecute, so the police left. So imagine this again. Can you get into your house?
Okay, this is how the second time.
Okay. Yeah. Can you get into your house?
No, I can't. He locked the door on
me. And you got hit in the head?
I got hit on
the
head.
Do you want to press charges?
Nope.
Do you promise to stay out here?
Yeah.
You realize that you don't have to be able to see him right now to press charges.
I didn't do anything.
No, that's not the...
No one said you did anything. No one's saying... We're asking what you're going to do.
Are you still mad about the incident with the stick?
No. I drank the milk. I'm fine.
I feel like... I think we're good here.
Yeah, I think so, too.
I think this thing...
Guys, as long as I can get in the apartment...
They give a timestamp... for the third time the cops are about to show up at this house. We were way off.
Oh, what was it?
Police, once again, were summoned back to the McGuffey abode around 1:45 p.m.
Oh, for the third time. For the third time. You were right. It was moments later.
And I want the cops to have driven all the way back to the station.
I know.
Yes. 1 p.m., I'm guessing 1:20.
It has to be.
And then 1:45.
They were on their way back when they're like, the dispatcher was like, you guys are going to have to go back to the McGuffey house.
No.
No.
They're like, we did everything we could.
We did everything.
We trusted them.
Here's
1:45.
One thing is obvious with these two, by the way, is that it's real love. Because at this point, you don't fight this much
right.
if your heart's not in it.
Yes.
Why you're not passionate
admit
about
you care about each other.
Yes. You just got to get to what the
you're
real
afraid
issue
he's
is.
Going to leave you. It's okay.
Yes.
Whether it's romantic or friendship, none of it matters. It's just feelings.
Guys, I'm looking at your body language, and I can tell there's a lot of love here.
There is. Look, you guys are telling the world you're
roommates.
I didn't do
anything. That's
fine.
I didn't do anything.
No one said you did a goddamn thing.
You're bleeding.
So I hit him?
Yeah, that's what you're doing.
I didn't do anything.
You're bleeding.
Right.
So it's 1:45.
1:45 for the third time.
Unbelievable.
Police again were summoned to the McGuffey abode. The roommate, who we still don't know, said McGuffey kept bothering him. He's bothering me. He's like, you could have told us that. Both times,
like a 6 and 7 year old in the back seat of a long car
ride?
Are
these guys calling or neighbors calling?
They're calling.
They're calling.
Yeah.
The roommate.
Excuse me, officer. He's bothering me.
Right. Mm. Don't look at him. And then you hear McGuffey in the background. I'm not touching you.
He's bothering me.
I didn't do anything.
Stop. The roommate said McGuffey kept bothering him, calling him a vulgar term for female genitalia.
Pussy.
Why didn't they just say pussy? Just calling him names.
Yeah.
They're going to get so weirdly
derogatory
between glass cups.
Profane names?
Yes.
Yeah, they can add names to a glass.
Wait, what was it? What is it? A slang? What is it?
They're calling
a vulgar
him
name
vulgar
for a woman's genitalia.
For female genitalia. Mm-hmm. Do you think that was the line for the roommate? You are rude now.
Yeah.
Like, I don't care.
There's only one of those terms that would actually make me hit people with a stick because I can't stand it so much.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the T. The T one. I don't even like saying it.
What?
Twat.
Oh.
I'm like, you don't like being called titty?
No. That's terrible. Are boobs genitalia?
No.
Boobs aren't genitalia. No, they're not.
Dan goes, ooh, that's a, ooh, oh, I'm dumb. No, yeah, no, they are definitely. No,
but it is a way to get milk. It is a way to get milk for your cup.
That's true.
So imagine this, like, walk it back. This started because unknown roommate drank milk out of a glass cup.
Out of McGuffey's glass cup.
And then McGuffey grabbed a wooden stick.
Threatened him with it.
They called the cops then.
Right.
That was like, which I meant was a lot of do it then.
That was a different time.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? So call him. I'd like to see you do that.
I haven't done a goddamn thing to you.
I haven't done anything.
You're the one who did something.
Calls him way back at 1 o'clock, which feels like a different time in this country.
By the way, he called him at 12:30.
Yeah, you're right.
12:30, they got there at 1.
Mm-hmm.
Standing in an aggressive
stance.
You're going
to stay away from each other in this place in which you both live?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
I didn't do anything.
I'm just hoping someone put the milk back in the fridge because, I mean, now we're working on 2
minutes.
Hours.
Nah, it's only 40 minutes at this point.
Okay, all right, that's true.
Yeah, but then he hits him in the head and he's like, okay, now we're here. You've been hit.
Yeah.
You're locked out of your house.
Yeah.
You want to press charges?
No.
There's
call him back.
So McGuffey called him the bad
name.
Yes, the genitalias that are oppressed. Pre suppressed charges.
McGuffey was then arrested and taken to jail.
Yeah, that's right.
Which I think at this point, the cops are like, we're not even asking you.
We just are tired of coming back here.
This is like a, I don't want to drive back to this place.
They get another call. Now we got all three of us got to go back.
Right.
Turns out I'm bothering me.
Yeah. This is what they wrote.
I'm bothering me.
McGuffey was arrested, taken to jail. It wasn't immediately clear what happened to the glass cup. Who cares?
Nobody cares. This is the dumbest journalist on the planet.
Yep.
I think his name's Will Greenlee or something. He writes all these up for this TC.
He's like, I'm going to put in all the facts. You guys sort it out.
I'm going to ask you guys, how old is Stephen McGuffey?
Too much fun leaves marks in life. Living hard, you'll pay the price. Who is gonna get it right? Guess the age.
So now,
like a Like so a McGruff, McGruff estimate?
What do we know about him? We know he has a roommate.
We know he likes milk.
He likes milk.
Still likes milk.
Two guys living together, likes milk, glass cup, has a specific cup.
Owns a stick.
Vero Beach.
See, it's weird with glass cup because you could be like 80-year-old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
3-year-old has their special cup.
If the twist is that these are toddlers, I will
go nuts.
Yeah, I like will you have, just saw up close. So
you don't drink. You don't drink another toddler's milk. And what if that's they didn't identify it? That could be breast milk,
right?
I don't know if you know you were breastfeeding in your
you
family.
Specifically.
No, in your family. But like one time, I had my wife's breast milk that she had pumped. She pumped the breast milk, which it's like this is liquid gold.
Yeah,
and I, by accident, it was in the middle of the night, and I fumbled it, and it spilled out onto our carpet. And, like, crane up me, like, looking at the sky, like, no!
So and she was like, there's no crying over spilled milk. And you said, actually, it's don't cry over spilled milk.
There's no crying in baseball.
And that's when she hit you with a stick.
That's right.
So they didn't say if it was an apartment or house. I'm asking you guys now.
Okay.
How old is Stephen McGuffey?
Now,
you are our guest.
You can either go first, third, or Tig, which is in the slot between the two of us.
Oh, okay. I'll go real quick.
Yeah.
This is in, where is this? In Florida?
Vero Beach.
Oh, man. That doesn't help at all.
Doesn't help at all. Mm-mm.
Okay.
Kind of
all right.
muddies
I'll
the water.
Tig. I'll go Tig.
Tig. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Jason.
46.
46.
I think
Jason's. What, you don't say yet, right?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I'm going to go with my gut when I first heard his name.
Mm-hmm. Right.
37.
37 years old.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I think he's 29.
29 years old. Okay,
yep.
Randy says.
He's still drinking at 29.
By the way, none of us think he's like 18 or 19.
No.
No one thinks he's elderly.
No.
Right. And Julian, you said?
37.
And Jason?
46.
46.
29 to 46. We have a range of 17 years.
Now, I should come clean now.
What?
I'm the roommate.
Oh! The
first time I've
ever. And you have less of an idea.
I was furious.
You get it wrong? You're like still 14 years off?
Here's the problem. I am a pussy. So I got so mad.
Fair enough.
Truth
Stephen McGuffey.
Yes.
With a wooden stick aggressive stance is 60 years old.
Oh, my God!
And for some reason, they took his mugshot while he was getting a haircut.
Oh, my God.
Why is he wearing a haircut apron?
By the way, from the front, looks great hair.
Yeah.
From the back.
60 years old fighting over a glass cup.
Now, in my defense, that's exactly the guy I pictured in my head, but in Florida, that's 37.
Right, that could be Florida 37.
That's a Florida 37. Let's be
honest. That's a Florida 37 as a 6-year-old.
You're right, though, Rand. He has two very distinctive different heads
looks.
Of hair.
Yeah. He's got the head of hair that he presents out front.
Yeah.
And then what's happening in the back.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like business in the front, foreclosure in the back.
They took his mugshot. The first shot, they're like, all right. And then they turn around, and then he did. And they're like, oh, you're free to go, sir. You're a different person.
We must have got the wrong man.
Yeah.
And of course, this will be posted on the Dumb People Town Facebook page.
Well, yes. There
so
you
that
go.
Everybody can get a good idea.
Oh, my goodness.
The podcast that you host is
Soft Spot Pod.
Please listen to us on it, and Dan will be on it soon at some point. It is really, it's a great podcast about people talking about soft spots in their lives, like things, music, movies, songs.
What do you go back to when you're feeling stressed out? It reminds you of being a simpler time, a happier time. Do you know what yours is off the top? One of them, Dan?
Kraft macaroni and cheese.
Oh, Kraft macaroni and cheese.
There you go. See, it's a
Did you say singles or
spirals? Okay, so
spirals.
That's something like totally different from this. Is
that's
why
a 45 minute conversation?
And, but this is. And by the way, this is the why I love
that show.
Hosting this show with Dan because. We have our things that we, you know, and Dan just immediately comes up with something completely different,
right.
Which is why I love doing the show, because it's a melding pot of many
Heck
different
yeah.
opinions. Thank you guys for listening, and we got to get back to work.
Dumb, 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 dumb. Stick around, make a sound, calm you down, it's Dumb People Town.
It's a good show.
Hello, I'm Dave Ross.
Hey, and I'm Hampton Yunt.
And we host Suicide Buddies on Starburns Audio.
That's right. It's a podcast about suicide, but not to make light of it. We actually talk about suicidal thoughts, depression, kind of with a sense of levity that Dave and I have with each other. And he's my best friend. Come on.
Yeah, we're buddies. Suicide Buddies.
That's the title.
One of our favorite episodes that we've recorded so far is about this guy, Jan Pataki, who was a Polish aristocrat in the 19th century. Mm-hmm. And he, one of the reasons it's possible that he killed himself is that he thought he was a werewolf.
Oh.
Check out a clip. It also makes me think, like, we were talking about in the Norway black metal episode, how, like, just the culture of your surroundings can affect you. Like, yeah. He's in a castle in Poland. He's like, I mean, if you lived in a castle in Poland and no one knew anything about anything, you might be like, I'm a bat. I'm probably a bat.
That's like literally what happened to Batman. He literally is in his mansion. He's like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm a bat.
Bat. I'm a bat. I'm a bat.
I'm
a bat that helps people.
I'm a bat that helps people.
I'm a rich...
I don't know what you want from me. And my girlfriend, she's a cat. She's a cat.
My girlfriend's a cat.
She steals things. She's a woman who steals things. She's a cat. I'm a bat.
I'm a bat.
I help people.
She's a cat. We fight a penguin.
Till the tears run down from my eyes, Lord, somebody, ooh, somebody, can anybody find me somebody to love?
Alexa, play hits from Queen.
Okay.
Somebody to love.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.